Hello, good afternoon, good morning, good evening, my fellow creative designers and content creators. Welcome once again to another exciting episode on this channel. And in today's episode, we are going to design beautiful wedding invitation flyer. As you are seeing on your screen, this is the raw design and this is the mock-up version. And guys, don't worry, I'm going to share this PSD file with you. So in case you have you also have a project to design, or you have a project to work on, and after designing, you can put it on a mock-up version like this and then send it to your client for approval. But basically, this is the raw design. So this is what we are going to work on, and then later on transform it to be like this. So guys, if this is the first time coming across this channel, please subscribe, like, comment and share, and let me know how this channel is helping you in any other form. So we launch the Photoshop at the beginning and you press on Ctrl N to open a new document, and we are going to use A4 size. My A4 size is here, 148 by 210, resolution is 300, or you can go to your art and illustration, you can go to your print and then just look for A4 is here. You select it this way, guys, select A4 this way, and then you type the name. I have the details here. In order not to waste too much time, I've typed everything. So Ctrl C to copy it, and then come and paste it here, wedding invitation flyer, and everything is okay. You click on create, and then you have a nice interface like this. So the first thing we are going to do is to work with the background. We are going to import the background to Photoshop. Okay, so guys, the background has successfully imported to Photoshop, and then let me reduce the size a bit. I think this is awesome. So this and this, I'll put them in a group, Ctrl G to call it background. And then somebody may ask, where did you get this beautiful background from? I had it from pinterest.com. A Pinterest is a website for graphic designers where resources, graphic design resources and graphic design inspirations can be picked from. All a lot of graphic design and details and things are there, so you can check it out if you are wondering how I was able to get this beautiful background. Check it out from pinterest.com, and then you can have a lot of more which are beautiful and attractive than this. So now the next thing is that you are going to pick up this text. You are invited. T on the keyboard to activate the text and hit here, boom, on the keyboard, Ctrl V to paste it, and then you are invited over there successfully. Now let me zoom it up again, and I think this is awesome. First of all, let's bring our guide, go to view, go to guide, and then new guide layout, and then set it to, let's see if here will be 6 and 5 is okay. So click on okay to set the guides, meaning we are going to make sure that everything falls within this range. Yes, everything falls within this range, and we are going to change this because we use a different color code for it. And if you look at this, this is here. And let's go and check the hex code, FFA 800. So that is it. Let me just quickly go and then go and hit here, Ctrl V to paste it, FFA 800, and that is awesome. Then you drag it, hold out to drag it like this, and then go and pick the next test, Ctrl C to pick it, and double click it this way. So you double click it this way, and then Ctrl V to paste it, and then that is for the solemnization. And the font is which font will you use, and I'm not sure this is the font, but I'll go and check it out very soon. Okay, so the font we use for the solemnization is Catalish Hintera. Yes, Catalish Hintera. So I'll post them for you to check it out and then download. So I'll drag it this way and scale it up to be very big, more than the you are invited. And then that is it. We are going to change the color to something green like this, and that was awesome. That is it. So push it up a bit, and this is awesome. So this, you drag it down and then go and pick this one, Ctrl C to copy it, double click it, and then Ctrl V to paste it, and this is awesome. We are going to draw a rectangle beneath it, and then make sure it is grouped perfect, and this is awesome. So we change this one to color white, Yes, color white, any of the background areas is okay. And then let's center and align this and this together. And I think Control D to deselect it. And that is awesome. That is awesome. That is awesome. So this should go up a bit. And then this also should go up a bit. And then we can put this and this in a group and Control G and call it top. So top text. All right. So our top text is set. And I think the solemnization, let's see something. This shape we created, it should have the same color code. Feel this. Perfect. Now everything is on course. Everything is on course. So we are going to pick the between, drag this down a bit, and then we are going to pick between. So between, perfectly fix, and then Control scale it up a bit and then push it down using your arrow key. So this is also inside. So we are done with these things. Now the next thing we are going to work on is the names. So this, you pick this name. This is Daniel. Control C to copy it, T on the keyboard and hit here, and Control V to paste it. And then we are going to use the same font for the solemnization. Yes, you are going to use the same font for the solemnization, and the color is also going to be green like this. Yeah, Control T to scale it up nicely like this, and then push it to this side. Awesome. So this, you scale this here, and then go and pick the next name, which is Martin. Control C, and then double click it, and you double click it, and then Control V to paste it. And we reduce the size to something like 15. It should be very small. Then put it beneath it. And I think 15 too is too small. So let's see, 20. And I think 20 is awesome. So these two names, let's take it out from the top test. And then these two names, you double click A, you select it and drag it this way. And then go and pick the Daniel, double click on the Daniel, and then go and pick the lady's name. Press Solar, Control C to, and then Control V to paste it. And this is awesome. So push it to hit this line, because we set a target for ourselves. And then, sorry, it should go up a bit. No, it should come down. And then the Martin, let's use the arrow key to bring it down a bit, and then come and pick the next name. Buediwa, Control C, double click inside here, and Control V to paste it. And then the name is getting set. Again, let's go to the ellipse, a rectangle tool, and then right click to pick the ellipse tool. Hold shift to draw a beautiful ellipse like this. Nice. And you can just leave the hex code or the background color to be green like this, and then push it to this side, and then go and pick your end. Control C to copy it, T on the keyboard, hit anywhere, Control V to paste it, and then you push it on it. Let's change it to color white, and then you center and align it so that it will be visible. Guys, you realize now it's shown. And then let's put these things in a group. Control J and then call it name, and then double click this side and call it names. All right, so the names is set, or the name are set. We are intact with it. Now I left with the date, time, and then a location and venue, RSVP, then we are done. So let's again go to this side and then go and pick September, Control C, and then hit here, Control V to paste it. And then you change it to that of the green. Yeah, Control C again, then transform it a bit this way, and then push it here, And this is awesome. This is awesome. Drag this one and then write the date, which is, I think, 28. Yes. Control T again, and then scale it up this way. And I think this is perfect. This is perfect. So push it here. And that is it. That is it. That is it. That is it. Let's go to the ellipse to right click and then pick a rectangle tool. And then hit here and draw a nice rectangle like this. Now go to the stroke, fill to no fill, and then go to the stroke and set the stroke to that of this color. Yes, that of this color. And then the stroke size should be 10 or so. Yes, it should be 10. If 10 is too small for you, then you can increase it to, let's say, 15. And depending on the size of the stroke you want, So let me push this to this side a bit, push it to close the gap a bit, and use the arrow key just to adjust it. And that is okay. Control A and let's center it. Control D to deselect it. And then I'll right click this side and then rasterize type. After rasterizing type, go and pick the rectangular marking tool and cut the edge away. Delete it. Cut the edges away. Just delete it. Good. Control D to deselect it. And go and pick your date. Sorry. We couldn't finish. Let's center this side again. And then delete it. And that is it. Control D to deselect it. And go and pick your Saturday. Control C. And then hit T on the keyboard. Sorry. You select the Saturday, Control C, come in here and hit key on the keyboard to activate the test tool. Control V to paste it, and then Saturday is done. Let's push it here and let's increase the size to something like 20. If 20 will be too much, we reduce it. 20 is okay. Drag it to this side and then go and pick your time, which is what, 7:30 a.m. Control C to copy it. Double click here. Double click this side. Control V to paste it. And that is it. You are good to go. Ooh la la. Gradually. So this is also set. The date is also set. Let's put everything in a group. Control G. Then call it date and time. Good. So that is also set. Now I left it what? The location. Left with the location. And I have my location icon here. I'll just drag it and then go and put it over there. Don't worry, I'll post everything for you to download it. Everything. All the resources file. Everything. I'll post them for you to download and then practice it for free. So I'll go and copy my location. This Control C to copy it. T on the keyboard, hit here, Control V to paste it. And that is it. V on the keyboard to activate the move tool and then position it well. So here I use a font called Trajan Pro. And then I position this here nicely. I think the location icon, I have to reduce the size a bit. Guys, everything that you are doing, just do it according to your liking, if you prefer it, and that's all. And then let's the backing details, Control C, and then let's drag it this way, double click it, and then Control V to paste it. And then you use, we're gonna use Arial, and then let's change it to say 15. And 15 too is too small, so open it up still. Open. And then change here to all caps. And I think the size 32 is too big. 20. And let's see, 20 is awesome. So we change the color to this color. Good. Guys, in fact, if you are following up to this point, and you say you cannot practice, then I don't know. Even this is a step-by-step details approach where beginners are following and they are practicing. So if you are a pro and then you are also on this channel, thank you. Please again subscribe to this channel, like, share, comment, and let me know what you think or your thoughts about this design. So this is also what the location or venue. Yes, so this is also the venue. And then the remaining aspect is what? The RSVP. So let's have it here. Control C to copy it. T on the keyboard, hit here. Control V to paste it. And we are going to use a Trajan Pro for the RSVP. So Trajan Pro for RSVP. And then increase the size to something like 30. Let it be big. Yes, let it be big. Let it be big. Then on the keyboard to move, to activate the move tool. And then we position it here. Now drag it, duplicate it using Control J or hold Alt to drag it to duplicate it. Now come and pick the contact detail, Control C, and then double click on this second one. Double click on it, Control V to paste it. And guys, oh la la, I believe you are following. So let's change that color to that of this. Yes, let's change that color to that of this. And guys, this is awesome. So Control J to put it in a group and call it what? RSVP. SVP. Oh la la. So it means we are moving further. And then the last one was we brought this thing. We brought this thing inside. Okay, so let's open the background session. Let's open the background session and go and bring it, introduce it inside, and then we did some magic or we did something to it so that it will look awesome. All right, so now it's done. So click on okay and then scale it up or resize it big like this, and then press enter and add layer marks. Inside the layer mask, click on B to activate the brush tool. And then the brush tool is showing here, we are using a soft round brush. We go to this side and then you set the soft round brush. Set the size to maybe 100, opacity to 100, flow is 100, and then smoothing to 10. And again, everything is okay. So now let's get back. Now hit here, deactivate the caps lock, and then increase the brush size and brush around it, and then let's set this to multiply and then opacity to somewhere 20. Good. And then it's inside like that. Very, very perfect. And then when we are done, we added something. I'll put it for you to download it. It's not in the resources, but I'll put it over there for you to download it and practice for free. Guys, you know I love you, that's why I've been doing everything for you for free. And then this size too, let's see, we put it on something like normal is okay. We just want it to be filled inside like that. So guys, this was the whole design. And guys, thank you for subscribing. Please subscribe to this channel, like, share, comment, and let me know how this tutorial is helping you. So please, if you have any wedding invitation flyer for your client and you have no idea on how to start, how to even finish, and how to just beautify everything up, come to my channel. DM me. My social media handles are all active. My WhatsApp line are active. Just hit me up and let me help you with PSD file if I have some. And then even if I have some end, due to my schedule or my time, I can design something for you. Trust me, I'll do it for you. We are brothers. That's why I always urge you to subscribe to this channel, like, share, comment, and let me know how this channel is helping you in any other way. Subscribe to my channel, like, share, comment, and let me see you in the other side. I love you. I'll see you in the next tutorials. Bye for now. Until then, peace.